guys, it's your girl Lucy, and I am back once again, guys, with another back video. So guys, today I'll be doing a cooking video. Finally, I know you guys have been wanting a cooking video. I know I've only done one on my channel, and this is cooking video number two. And today I'll be making some mac and cheese. So this is gonna be minced mac and cheese. And last time I did a breakfast video, this is now dinner. If you call it dinner, you call it supper, you call it evening food, whatever you call it, but I'll be doing dinner today. So it is minced mac and cheese. So I know you guys haven't seen a lot of tutorials on my YouTube channel, but I have quite a lot of them on my TikTok. So make sure to follow my TikTok at Lucy aka Savage. Make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, make sure to click that subscribe button, and be sure to be the first to comment on this video so you can get a post notification shout out. But without further ado, get your drinks ready, get your snacks ready, because you're in for a treat today. So guys, first things first, I have to show you guys my three main ingredients. This is going to be very simple and easy. So basically, one of my first main ingredients is obviously my macaroni. And my next ingredient would be lancewood cheese, which is going to be the last ingredient. And then mince. So this is some, you guys can also, I know you guys also call it ground beef. So I've got my ground beef right here. I've got my cheese and I've got my macaroni. So first things first, I'm going to go take a bowl and I'm gonna put my macaroni inside and pour some water and just wash out all the starch, because normally if you just like throw the macaroni straight into the pot without rinsing it a few times, a lot of starch will be trapped in there. So you don't want those like gooey white stuff in your macaroni. So what I'm gonna do is go quickly grab a bowl and pour this macaroni inside, rinse it up a little, and then remove the starch, and it will be ready to get boiling. And then we're gonna move on to doing our mince. I'm gonna chop up some onion, I'm gonna chop up some green pepper, throw that in oil, mix that up, add some paprika and some thyme. Let's just get into this video, guys, because I don't want to explain everything while I'm standing here. So yeah, let's first start by adding. So guys, I've got my bowl right over here and I've also got my macaroni. So I'm just gonna pour a little oil of that inside. And then I've got my jar of water right here and I'm just gonna pour that all inside. Okay, I'm gonna give that a little stir. Let me just grab a spoon right here. I'm gonna give that a little stir and just sort of trying to rinse all of that starch out before adding it in the pot, obviously. As you keep stirring, you'll notice that it actually, the water turns white, which is basically all the starch being released. So we're just gonna rinse all of that. And then I'm going to let this water go down the drain, add new water, put it in a pot, and let that boil. So guys, I've got my pot right here that I'm gonna add the macaroni in. I've got a new jar of clean water. I've got my rinsed macaroni, and I'm just gonna pour all of that inside. And then, I'm gonna take my new jar of water and put that in. Okay, and then we're gonna take the lid, close that, and go to the stove area, place that on, and then I'm just gonna turn on my heat at the highest so that it starts heating up. Guys, I've got my chopping board right over here and I've got my full onion and I'm just gonna dice this. I'm probably gonna do half of it, I'm not so sure, but I'm just gonna dice these onions and I'm just probably gonna do I don't know, a half, but yeah. Okay. So guys, I've chopped up all my onions and I'm just gonna literally pour that in my bowl. And after that, I'm gonna chop up some tomatoes. So keep them in the background because I'm not music in the background. And then now onto chopping my tomatoes. I'm just gonna cut in the middle of that. Take out that little middle area because no one wants that in their food. and yeah, start dicing them up. I've chopped up all my tomatoes yet again, and I'm also gonna literally toss it all in the bowl, making sure that all the juices stay in the bowl. I love all those tomato juices. It's just gonna make this meal even more tastier. So, whoops, my pot is overloading. I'm just gonna turn down the hot volume to 2, and yeah, it's so. What I'm going to do is grab my spoon and just cook as much macaroni, just mix it up, because I don't want it sticking at the bottom. So I normally come every 5 minutes to do this. As you can see, it's still cooking up. And then I'm gonna take some salt and I'm gonna measure 1 tablespoon of salt. Okay, that's 1/2 tablespoon. And the other half, there we go. And place that right there and give it one more stir again. We want our macaroni to have taste, so obviously I have to add some salt. And I'm just gonna close the lid once again, but I'm gonna let a little hole out so that it can breathe, because I don't want it over flooding again. Back onto the tomato. Okay, so I was still pouring this in the bowl. I was rudely interrupted by the macaroni, but that's sorted. Okay, so I got 2 of my ingredients placed right over there. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go grab a pot that I'm going to cook my mince in with these vegetables. Well, I'm not going to call them vegetables because it's only 2. Sorry, guys. That's my absolutely cute niece. And she's everywhere right now. So I actually got her while making the dinner. Go sit there. Say hi.
Hi.
Okay, guys, so I'm gonna go grab a pot and I'm going to add some oil, first starting with my onions and then add some spices. So let's go grab the pot quickly. So guys, I've got my onions right over here, and what I'm gonna do is throw those in the oil straight in. Okay, I'm gonna just put all of those inside. Grab a fork and stir that up. So next up, I'm going to go grab some paprika. So I'm just going to open this up and I'm going to grab some thyme, some paprika. Yeah. So I've got my thyme right over here, so I'm just going to sprinkle a little thyme for some, like, taste. So I'm just going to grab some thyme and just sprinkle a lot of that in. I love some thyme and everything. And then I'm gonna have a little bit of paprika, which is like this red curry powder. Just like 1/2 spoon of that. Close that. And then I'm gonna stir that up again. I'm gonna stir that up. And it smells absolutely amazing. So I've got my ground beef right here. I'm gonna open it up and throw that in. Take that and drop it inside. Literally. Okay. And then I'm gonna try break this apart. I'm just gonna close the pot for 5 minutes and let this mince at least turn brown, and then I'm gonna stir it up with all the onions. So I'm just gonna mix this up. So guys, I've let my mince get a little brown for a little bit, for like 5 minutes or so, and I've got it right over here. So I'm going to add all my seasonings. So as you can see, I've got some Mrs. Ball's chutney. I've got some Rob spice. This is some black pepper. I've got, same from Robinson Spices, this is the Shisanyama seasoning. I've got Maggie all-purpose seasoning, and I've got some salt. So starting off with is the salt. I'm gonna put 2 teaspoons of salt. one tablespoon of salt. What am I saying? 1 tablespoon of salt. I'm gonna add some. Then I'm gonna add some black pepper, and I'm just gonna open that. So I normally season black and pepper, like I say, they're best friends, and you have to always add black pepper. Black salt and pepper definitely go together. And then I'm gonna add some all-purpose seasoning, and I'm just gonna like dab it a little few times. 1, 2, 3, 4, just 2 splashes. And some Shisanyama seasoning. I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit of that on top just to give the meat a nice like barbecue taste. So I'm just gonna sprinkle a bit of that inside. And then we're gonna stir it all up together. And I'm just gonna, that looks amazing. It smells amazing. It looks amazing. And I'm sure it will taste amazing. And last but not least, the chutney. I'm gonna go take my chutney, my Mrs. Ball's chutney, and I'm just gonna add a good amount of that. Let me just measure it. There we go. 1 teaspoon is enough because chutney is really sweet, so I'm not trying to over add it because it's gonna taste really sweet. We want the savory, not sweet. So I'm just gonna stir that up a little bit more. And oops. Close it. And I'm gonna let it simmer for 10 minutes and it should be ready by the time I'm done. So I'm just gonna turn down the stove a little bit at 5 so that it could simmer and not burn. So yeah, I'm gonna put all these seasonings away and I'll see you guys in a bit. Don't run away. I just added the tomatoes. I'm so sorry I didn't get that on camera. And I also added some spaghetti bolognese so that this is really nice and creamy. So I'm just mixing all of that together. And it is. I'm just going to close that again one more time for at least another 10 minutes. And let's go on to our macaroni. It is nice and ready. Perfectly ready. And we're going to combine this together in a bigger pot. So my macaroni is nice and ready, as you can see, really soft. So I'm gonna close that, leave it to cool down a bit, and I'm just gonna leave this mince for 10 minutes. So I'll see you guys after the mince is ready, and then I'm gonna combine these two. Add some mozzarella cheese, not mozzarella, cheddar cheese, and then pop that in the oven. Now my mince is absolutely ready. It is looking absolutely good. I've got this pot right here, this clean pot over here, and this is where I'm going to mix the mince and the macaroni. So I'm just gonna grab the macaroni out and pour all of that macaroni into this pot. Okay. I'm going to take this macaroni, all of it in there. Okay, and then I'm going to take my mince and I'm gonna go pour it right on top of this macaroni, and it's looking delightful. I'm just gonna all of that in. Okay. And then I'm gonna mix all of this together. Hey guys, so my macaroni is looking delightful. I've mixed it with the mince, and now what I'm gonna go do is I'm gonna grab my grater right here, and I grab my Lancewood cheddar cheese right here, and I'm just gonna cut that open, and I'm gonna grate some cheese that I'm going to add on top of this. So I'm just gonna open that and grate a quarter of it. got my cheese up and ready, and what I'm gonna do is sprinkle all the cheese on top of the macaroni. So I'm just gonna grab a good amount of that and just sprinkle it on. I've added a good amount of that cheese all over the macaroni, and I'm going to grab my lid, close it, and I want to let the cheese melt on top. So there's not really a timing for this. As long as the cheese is melted on top of the macaroni, then it's ready to go and ready to be dished up. So I'm gonna grab my lid and I'm gonna close this up, and as soon as I open it again, it will be melted all over the macaroni. My macaroni is finally ready. Come check out the finished results. So my cheese is absolutely perfectly melted. So now I'm going to dish up the first plate of the macaroni, and I'm just gonna grab and I'm just gonna cut a piece out. So I'm just gonna cut it in half first. Look at that cheese stretching. Okay. And then I'm just going to grab a good amount of that, take my plate, check at that cheese, look at that, just look how amazing that looks. The cheese is absolutely melting everywhere, and I'm trying to make this dish as neat as possible, but I've got it right here, and I'm going to have a taste test. Have it right here, and I'm gonna get a taste test, and I'm just gonna grab a fork, so let's get tasting. Okay, I'm gonna grab a good amount of that macaroni with the cheese. Okay. That is absolutely divine. It is really good. I really advise you guys to try and make this at home, because it's really quick. It's literally oil, onion, tomato, mince, mix that up, boil some macaroni, toss it in, mix it up, add some cheese, and done. And it's a really quick 1 hour type of dinner, so I really advise you guys to try this, because it tastes amazing. So guys, make sure of this video, make sure to give this video a big thumbs up, make sure to click the subscribe button, and be first to comment on this video. So for today's post notification shout outs, let's get a drum roll please. Today's post notification shout out goes to Leah Hlongwane. Thank you so much for commenting on my last makeup tutorial. Thank you so much for giving this video a big thumbs up, and I'll see you guys in the next video. I am out. Bye.